Hello and welcome to Answering ATPL. In this video, we focus on the subject of general navigation under the topic Basic of Navigation, subtopic The Earth, titled The Earth Properties. Scope of this video, formation of Earth, shape of the Earth, poles, equator, circumference and diameter, and vertex. Formation of Earth. The Earth was formed approximately 4.6 billion years ago, likely as a result of a supernova. This supernova produced hot gases cloud. These hot gases are swirling and clumped together because of gravity. It was then cooled down and solidified to form a planet that we all know as the Earth. This process not only creates Earth, but the entire solar system. Of course, this is the simplified version of the story. If you're interested to find out the whole story, check out the description section for reference. Shape of the Earth. Due to the nature of Earth's formation, Earth is not a perfect sphere. The rotation of the mass that created the Earth produced centrifugal force. Due to this force, the Earth is wider in the middle and slightly flat at the top and bottom. This phenomenon is known as compression or ellipticity. The shape of the Earth is known as ellipsoid or oblate spheroid. However, for navigation purposes, it can be considered as a sphere. The Earth has two axes. Semi-major axis, also known as equatorial radius, is the distance from the Earth's center to equator, marked by the green line, and semi-minor axis, also known as polar radius, is the distance from its center to the north or south pole, marked by blue line. The value of Earth's compression or ellipticity is 1 over 298. This value is taken from ATPL learning objective documents. However, there is a question from the database that mentioned the value as 1 over 297. To use the Earth compression value, let's look at a sample question taken from Aviation Exam Database question number 40526. Value for the ellipticity of the Earth is 1 over 297. Earth's semi-major axis as measured at the equator equals 6,378.4 km. What is the semi-major axis in kilometer of the Earth at the axis of the poles? We know that the Earth's semi-major axis is larger compared to the Earth's semi-minor axis. Thus, semi-minor axis equal to semi-major axis minus open parenthesis semi-major axis multiply by compression value close parenthesis equal to 6,378.4 minus 6,378.4 multiply by 1 over 297 equal to 6,356.9 km. Poles. Definition. Poles are the point of intersection between the Earth's axis and the surface of the Earth. To illustrate the definition, here on the screen is a model of the Earth. As you can see, the Earth is rotating on its axis. If we mark this axis, in this case using the yellow line, the point where the axis intersect the surface of the Earth is known as poles. On the top is known as North Pole and the bottom one is known as South Pole. Equator. Definition. Equator is a line notionally drawn on the Earth equidistant from the poles, dividing the Earth into northern and southern hemispheres and constituting the parallel of 0 degree. Here on the screen is a model of the Earth. The green line represents the equator. Facts that we need to know about equator are: it is 90 degree to the Earth's axis. It divides the Earth into Northern Hemisphere and Southern Hemisphere. Diameter and circumference. Distance from the pole to equator is 10,000 km or 5,400 nautical miles. If you look at the diagram, the angle between pole and equator is 90 degrees. 90 degrees change in latitude equal to 5,400 nautical miles. 1 degree equal to 5,400 over 90. 1 degree equal to 60 nautical mile. We know that 1 degree equal to 60 minute. 60 minute equal to 60 nautical mile. Thus, 1 minute equal to 1 nautical mile. Remember, this value can only be used with grid circle. Distance along latitude can be calculated by using departure formula. Other type of distance calculation on the surface of the Earth is outside the scope of general navigation subject. As mentioned earlier, Earth can be considered as a sphere for navigation purposes. Thus, the circumference of the Earth is approximately 40,000 km or 21,600 nautical miles. Because the Earth can be considered as a sphere, to calculate the diameter of the Earth, we can use circumference formula. Here is the diagram of a circle representing a sphere that had been cut into half. From the center of the sphere to its outer edge is the radius. Formula for circumference is circumference equal to 2 pi r, where r is radius. As we all know, for a circle, 2 times radius is equal to diameter. Thus, we can rewrite the formula as circumference equal to pi d, where d is diameter. Thus, diameter equal to circumference over pi. Vertex. What is vertex? The position where the great circle reaches its highest latitude is called the vertex of that great circle. It exists in all great circles except equator and meridian. The fact that you need to remember about vertex are: every great circle have two vertices. Northern vertex in the northern hemisphere and southern vertex in the southern hemisphere. It is antipodal to each other. Latitude is opposite. If we were given northern vertex as 60 degrees north, the southern vertex should be 60 degrees south. Longitude is a bit complicated compared to latitude. Imagine we look at the sphere from the position indicated by the red arrow. The two white dots is the vertex. To find its longitude, it is easier if I remove the plane of the vertex shaded in blue and connect the two vertices by a straight line. The solid green line represents prime meridian of 0 degree longitude and the dashed green line represents 180 degree longitude. If we were given northern vertex longitude of 140 degree east, the angle between prime meridian and the northern vertex must be 140 degree. Since both vertices are connected by straight line, the angle between the two must be 180 degree. We want to find the angle shown on the screen. If we subtract both value, we will be left with 40 degree. Since it is west of prime meridian, the value will be 40 degree west. The other properties of great circle that have vertices that we need to understand: it will cut equator at longitude plus minus 90 degree from northern and southern vertex. The red crosses represent the position where the great circle cut the equator. If we look at the diagram from the top, 90 degree from the vertices should look like this. The angle from prime meridian to the northern vertex is 140 degree. We need to find this angle. 140 degree minus 90 degree is equal to 50 degree. Since it lies east of the prime meridian, the longitude will be 50 degree east. Its opposite shall be 130 degree west. The last properties of vertex that you need to remember is great circle direction at vertex is 090 degree or 270 degree. To better visualize this situation, the white line represent meridian and green line represent great circle track. If you look closely at all this position, the great circle cut the meridian at angle less than or more than 90 degree, except at this position. If you notice, this position is the position with highest latitude, which is a vertex. If you travel on the opposite direction, The direction will be 270. That's all for now. Please subscribe to my channel and press bell icon in order to get notified when I publish more content explaining ATPL theories and questions. Please hit like and share. Thank you very much. Have a nice day. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe and check out other videos.